Barnett's Whately at Watermelon Thursdays.
Yeah,
it's got, I think that has a nicer ring to it than Wednesdays, so I think you should keep having them on Thursdays. But I've got quite the crew with me tonight, and I'm really excited to be here, and thanks for coming out. And we're going to play some tracks. This is, I guess, officially a CD release party, so we're going to play a bunch of tunes off of my new CD, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, we're no longer in that band, but it was a fun ride while it lasted, and we recorded that one with those guys on the CD, and that last one was called Hop the Train to Hudson, and I wrote it after this really interesting journey to Gray Fox Bluegrass Festival I had a couple years ago to get to a Deadly Gentleman set, and the only way I could get there was to actually hop a train, because they were completely sold out of tickets, and there was just no other way to get there. So I snuck past the guy selling tickets, and or checking the tickets, and I hopped on the train, and there was the engineer, you know, and so I just snuck into the bathroom and hid for the entire two-hour ride to Hudson. So. Hop the train to Hudson. I'm a vagabond. What can I say? Although my parents are here tonight, so I shouldn't say that. So I have some amazing friends here tonight, and I'll introduce everybody as we go, but I wanted to bring up another good friend who's not up here at the moment to sing this next one. You may have seen her with a group called Joy Kills Sorrow. She's an amazing singer. Make welcome Emma Beaton. Here's a sad song for you.
Thank you. Thank you.
gonna try it. We're trying to boost the sound a little bit. Hopefully this will. So again, that's Emma Beaton singing for you guys. We're gonna do a traditional bluegrass tune for you, and it's called "I Just Think I'll Stay Around." City. It was our first one, which was just pure genius of me to book the very first one in New York City at Joe's Pub, one of the nicest venues there. And then it was just a good warm-up, you know, for my parents' house concert in a couple days. And then we had the Wizard Lounge last night in Cambridge, and here we are tonight in the Watermelon Thursdays.
Yeah. Moving up.
Yeah. And let's see, what do we got next? We're sort of, you know, we got some, oh,
Let's do,
So, on the guitar, we've done some playing together in the David Grisman Sextet until very recently, for about 4 years together. And he's one of my favorite guitar players, and he has a great solo project out on his own. And this is the first track of that. That's Grant Gordy.
Don't let that fool you. It's not solo guitar. Never mind. This is named after, I think we can all agree, probably one of easily the top 50 dinosaurs ever to exist.
Hey, man.
Top 50 winged prehistoric creatures, I think, ever to be put in a vote. Now, what do I do now? Where am I?
Sorry. Everyone's favorite pterosaur.
Really?
Yeah.
That the distinction?
Yeah.
Wow. Well, easily in the top 100 pterosaurs. This is called, this used to be called Pterodactyl on the Turnpike.
I know I'm supposed to start the song, but this is really entertaining. I'm just going to see how far it goes.
Yeah, this will take a while. So, it used to be called Pterodactyl on the Turnpike. Like with the, you know, Pterodactyl goes PT Aerodactyl. And then it was going to be like PT Aerodactyl, PT Earnpike. So that was the joke. But we quickly realized it would be way over the heads of a lot of listeners. I like the alienating music, it was shortened to just Pterodactyl. So all of that notwithstanding, Mike Barnett's going to present Pterodactyl.
Pterodactyl on the Turnpike.
That's right, yeah, boys. That's cool.
Thank you.
here to sing this next one. That was Grant Gordy on the guitar. Song and then take a quick break and come back for one more set. think we'll do the title track off the CD. Before we go, introduce our bass player. He's woo. It's been a long day. He's from New York City. He's been there a little over 10 years, and he runs the bluegrass and swing jams at Mona's. He's a great guy. That's Jared Engel on the bass. This one's called One Song Romance. Manly. because you care.
Do you just care?
We care too. One, two, oh. Yeah.
More strings?
One, two, three. This one's called Light Me a Lantern.
Thank you.
Alright, we're going to do a honky-tonk song for you now that we've never done before. How are you guys for a forgiving audience? Are you guys having a good time tonight? It's a pleasure to be back here. Wes and I played here some years ago. Now it feels like a lifetime ago with our old band. So it's nice to be back and have such delicious food and watermelon.
And you're still with me.
Yeah, I get to spend time with Wes.
Even more time with me.
And I get to gaze into your eyes, Wes.
Ooh, la la.
This song, this one's for you.
Whoa.
It's
wow.
Called, Can I Go Home With You?
I mean, we can all go back to Boston tonight.
Yep, good choice.
Okay, so it's all the same form. There's going to be chorus and verse and chorus, some sick solos, and then another verse and a chorus.
Yeah.
I hope this part is going on TV too.
Okay, tempo. Too fast.
No,
that's not.
Oh,
story to tell you. No, it's not really that long ago. I just didn't know how to start segue into me talking, but I can now I've started talking, and so I'm having an existential crisis now. Anyway, so we thought it would be appropriate since you know our band leader is the fearless, indomitable, and prolific Mike Barnett. His nickname is sometimes Dr. Barnetto, sometimes just good old Barnes. And so it just so happens that I have a brand new tune that I just wrote all by myself that's named after another wonderful musician who happens to be an incredible banjo player and polymath living in Port Townsend, Washington by the name of Danny Barnes. Are you guys familiar with him? Well, you should get hip because he's really a fantastic human being and musician. He was with a band called the Bad Livers for a bunch of years. A name which I just realized how fantastic that is. It's a really great band name. Anyway, Danny is just a fantastic guy. So anyway, I wrote this tune and dedicated it to him, and it's entitled Danny Barnes. So here we go, Danny Barnes. Thank you.
Thank you.
So we're gonna do a. I'm not the murderous type, I don't think yet, but we're gonna do a murder ballad that that I wrote that Tim O'Brien sang on the CD, and he couldn't make it tonight, so I'm filling in. This is called Little Darling.
One, two, three, four.
The reason that
everyone who's in this room right now, Mike Barnett.
So we have one more to play for you, and there are CDs back there, and we'll all be hanging out afterwards for a little while, so please come say hi. This one's called Bottom of the Barrel. It wasn't exactly bottom of the barrel for tunes for the CD, but but I called it that. Don't ask me why.
I think it kind of fits the vibe somehow.
It does. It does. We'll take a vote afterwards. Here we go. Thanks again.
What are you gonna do? Let's do Shane and do a breakdown.
Okay. Skip it really fast.
Yeah.
Found my calling, fronting a show.
Woo!
Great. This one's called Shenandoah Breakdown.
Is this a Scrubs tune?
This is Bill Keith.
Bill Keith tune.
Really?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Good to know. Yeah. Regardless, one of my favorite tunes. Yeah.
Close enough. One, two. 1, 2, 3.